Hey, I'm Cameron McKenzie at cameronmcnz on Twitter, and I wanted to talk to you about Docker, specifically installing it on a fresh, clean Ubuntu 20.0 instance, and then maybe even pulling a container from DockerHub and running it. I got the hello world, and I've also got a special little Spring Boot microservice I'm going to try and run as well. As you can see here, I've got a base install of Ubuntu 20.04, and the only thing I've done here is add the terminal to my favorites. I put a little bit of text inside of this text file to guide me through the installation of Docker on Ubuntu, and I've also got a little Firefox browser open to my DockerHub account where I've got a Docker container hosted over there called Rock Paper Spring. Thought it might be nice to prove that Docker is installed on Ubuntu successfully by running that little Spring Boot microservice container. Okay, so first things first, what do you want to do? Well, you want to update the app package index and make sure that we can install all of our components over HTTPS. So we first do the sudo apt-get update, throw my password in there. And once that's done, the next line is installing all of these components here. As I said, this will allow me to do the update over HTTPS. So that means installing apt-transport, CA certificates, curl, gnupg-agent, some software common properties. Anyways, that all gets in there and it gets done fairly quickly. Once that's done, we use the curl that we just installed to grab Docker's official GPG key. There we go. It doesn't take long to download a GPG key. Once we've got that, we want to grab the stable devs, the stable binaries, the stable information about Docker. So we go to downloads.docker.com. I'm on the Focal version of Ubuntu. I want a stable release. You could have a test release. You could have a nightly release too. And now we're going to add all of the information about that dev to our local repository. And this should only take a second. And once this completes, we're going to do the sudo apt update once again. You can never, ever do the sudo apt update too many times. Might even do a little sudo apt cache policy just to see what we've got available to us. So what happens here? We got all sorts of different archives available. Gee, that's too much for me to even keep track of. You know what? I'm just going to do the basic install docker-ce. I'm not going to specify a version or anything like that. I'm going to say sudo apt-get install docker-ce, docker-ce-cli, container-d.io, and that's going to go ahead and that's going to install Docker if I click yes on that yes, no option. Okay, that's complete. It might be nice to take a look at the version of Docker that we're running. So we'll do a sudo docker version 20.10.3. I'm pretty happy with that. Maybe we can take a little look at the status, see if the process is actually running. It looks like we've got everything running. It's active, it's running. I'm pretty happy about that. You know, anytime you install Docker, it is customary to do the old Docker hello world. So I'm going to do a sudo docker run hello world. Hello world is a container hosted over on DockerHub. And you see it says, hey, I can't find this image locally is that first command, but it searches for it. It downloads it. It says it's pulling it from DockerHub. It downloads it and it says, hey, hello from Docker. That's all it does. It's not that interesting, but it proves that things are working. It's also cool if you go sudo docker images, you'll notice that that hello world image is registered. Now, I've got a little container over on Docker Hub. It runs on port 8080, so I got to do a little razzle dazzle if I want that one to run. So I do sudo docker run. It runs internally on port 8080. I'm going to map that to port 8088 and say, hey, I want to run my rock, paper, scissors container. I'll click enter. Notice it again says, can't find Cameron McKenzie locally, but there is this one over on dockerhub.com, hub.docker.com. There's my account and there's the little repository that we are trying to download. It's only going to take a second. You notice it's a Spring application. You can see the Spring banner that just came up there a second ago. I'm going to drag up there to see if we can see it just to prove what it is. You can see Spring there. See some references to Hibernate and JPA in there because that Spring Boot application uses that for a little bit of persistence. Only took about 7.5 seconds for that to run. And now let's see if we can run that locally in our browser. So it's localhost colon 8080. And of course I mapped it to localhost 8088. And so you got to have the right port mapping. Otherwise, of course, it's not going to work. And there we go, index.html like I had originally, except I didn't have the right port number. And then there's our little rock, paper, scissors game. So can we play the game? You can keep playing rock, paper, and scissors if you can figure out the trick. Well, you can win every time. But there you go. That's a little Spring Boot application running in Docker, pulled from DockerHub, all within just about 5 minutes doing the installation. And that's about it. And there you go. That's how easy it is to install Docker on Ubuntu 20 and run a couple of containers from Docker Hub, including the Hello World and a beautiful little rock, paper, scissors done with a Spring Boot. Now, if you enjoyed that tutorial, why don't you head over to theserverside.com. I'm the editor-in-chief over there. We've got lots of great tutorials on Spring, Docker, DevOps, you name it. If you're interested in my personal antics, you can always follow me on Twitter at cameronmcnz and subscribe on the YouTube.